In the first part of this series, you started a fun illustration from shapes and freeform lines. But we're not done yet. If you look at it, right now it looks like really simple artwork made of shapes. So how do we get it from this to this? To make an illustration look more polished and professional, some important things to think about are softness, emphasis, and texture. Now, in this tutorial, we'll help you focus on some of the most common and useful features so you can enhance your illustration. You'll learn how to round the corners of shapes so you can soften the art. You'll apply different size stroke weights so you can add some dimensionality and interest. And you'll add some texture with something called the blob brush tool. Now, I know you want to get started in the tutorial, but first, let's look at some examples. The first thing we'll explore is softness. What do I mean by that? Look at these two pencil designs. Which one would you say has harder edges? Which one looks softer? On the left, all of the corners are 90 degrees, which creates hard edges. But on the right, we've rounded the corners to create a softer look. Now, there's no right or wrong here. It just depends on the look you're going for. To add that softness to shapes, you can select a corner with the direct selection tool, and a corner radius widget appears. Drag one of those, and you've got rounded corners. Now, another way to refine your illustration is to add some emphasis, and you can do that by adjusting stroke weights. A stroke is a border on a shape or a line. Look at the lines of this notebook. You can minimize the stroke thickness to create a more subtle look, or emphasize them by making them thicker. You can make the stroke thicker or thinner by adjusting it in the Properties panel. To take your illustration to the next level, you can add some texture and whimsy by drawing freeform shapes using the blob brush tool. Now, with a tool like the pencil tool, you can make lines, or what we call paths. With the blob brush tool, you can make shapes filled with color. The blob brush is great for adding texture, or to create shapes that look more hand-drawn, or for filling areas of color for shading. I love these techniques because they're easy and fun, and they're some of the most popular ways to finesse your illustrations. Now it's your turn. Start this tutorial with step-by-step instructions so you can practice making an illustration look more polished and professional.